in this deal. We have a bell. How about a brass bell to go with a brass duck? I can't think of a better combination than a duck and a bell. Look at this fine bell. It is 7 inches high. It's a tri-colored bell, and it has the twisted handle and the twisted tapering fluid base for $26.75. But that's not all. We're going to complete the deal. A vase. A tri-colored fluted vase with a graceful teardrop shape. Look at the tri-color in there. Something completely different. And the slanting columns of copper, silver, and bronze. Now this measures almost 6 inches high and 2 inches wide. Chuck Spicer is already pacing the studios with his midnight show. Yes, he is.
Gold, gold, gold.
You have gold in your show.
Something new.
Yes, gold will be coming up at the Midnight Madness Hour. So stay tuned for Chuck Spicer. He will be along for the ride through the gold rush. Chuck has got his 49er gear already. So it looks like Steve Young. In the meantime, three pieces of tri-color brass. Where is my calculator? All that hour of power stuff got me out of control here for a minute. But in the meantime, you're paying $8 in change for each piece of brass. Look at the shine on that. And I've got calls available everywhere. Hello, you're live on the show.
Hi.
Hi, who is this, please?
Suzanne Williams.
Suzanne, what do you think about this trio of brass?
I think it's beautiful. I ordered two.
Are you picked up on two sets?
Yes.
What do you think about getting the bell and the duck and the vase?
It's a great deal because you would usually pay $26 for one of them.
You would pay $26 for one.
Yes.
So maybe we're talking as much as $75 to $80 for the set then.
Right.
Pretty good savings for you, Suzanne.
Yes.
Do you do a lot of decorating in brass, do you?
Yes, well, I have some brass.
Right.
Well, I have a brass end table.
Oh, nice. Well, this should be nice, nice compliment to that.
Mm-hmm.
Good. I'm glad you're able to find them, Suzanne.
Mm-hmm.
And I hope you enjoy the rest of our program.
Okay.
All right. Take care of yourself, Suzanne.
You too.
Bye-bye now.
Bye-bye.
Ladies and gentlemen, moments remain on the trio of brass because at this moment, we are going to have to be moving along to more. Let's take that away, and we have coming up the ring I've been talking about for you guys for over an hour now.
We're TV 51, WTVE, Reading.
Kutztown University, originally established to train teachers for the classrooms of Pennsylvania, has come a long way. Kutztown has grown into a vibrant, multifaceted university, boasting 5 specialized colleges, more than 50 degree programs, and over 6,900 students. Still, we continue to produce excellent teachers at such a rate that most of the active teachers in our 5-county service area graduated from Kutztown.
The following special program is brought to you by the AT&T family, Meridian Bank, Metropolitan Edison Company, Ludgate Engineering Corporation, the R.M. Palmer Company, and by Reading Eagle Company.
In 1963, Berks County felt its first casualty of the Vietnam War. And in the 9 years that followed, 61 more would also fall, and 3 others would be listed as missing, their fate still unknown. On September 24, 1988, right here in City Park, a memorial was dedicated to these fallen heroes and to all those who served in Vietnam. Tonight, this program takes a look at the dedication ceremonies and the memorial itself, that we may see how it came to be and why it was needed.
A Time of Healing, the story behind the Berks County Vietnam Memorial.
AT&T, we are proud to number among our family members many Vietnam-era veterans. They bring to AT&T the same spirit, the same courage, the same honor they brought to our country. At AT&T, we remember.
My brother was 18 in 1965, and I was 10. Mike was a private first class in the Marine Corps. He joined the Marines right after high school. I remember the family going over and watching him sign up. He was one of the first in Berks County to be killed over there. It was at the very early stages of Vietnam.
Reading Eagle Company is proud to have been part of the creation of the Vietnam Memorial. Through the effort of our employees, the Reading Eagle and the Reading Times provided extensive coverage of the dedication and the events leading up to it. Bill Kearns and Andy Lewandowski of our pressroom staff and Tom Stout of our editorial staff are Vietnam veterans who worked very hard to make the memorial dream a reality. And we are proud of the way the people of Berks County pulled together in this effort. Reading Eagle Company will remember.
Everyone loves a parade, but there was no parade on March 29, 1973. No brass bands, no marching girls, no confetti-strewn streets. Our men were coming home, and the nation didn't notice. Times had changed. As the 60s gave way to the 70s, Woodstock meant more than Snoopy's companion. The only doughboys came from Pillsbury, and war was now a four-letter word.
When the first demonstration started, the first things like that happened, I was very, very resentful, you know, that these young people that were here in this country could stand up and make all of this big hoopla, you know, when my son and Marie's son and May's son, different ones were, you know, over there fighting for what I had thought was a very patriotic reason. As time went on, I wasn't quite so judgmental, and I think that that maybe they had a very, very valid reason for doing these things. Not that I agreed with everything they did.
Americans no longer blindly saluted the flag and followed our nation's leaders. They asked questions and questioned answers about whether or not our country had any business being in Vietnam. More than a few felt we didn't and made their objections known, often loudly, sometimes violently.
We are the right guys. We did what we thought was right for the country. It really didn't matter what your political views were back then. Fine, if you wanted to go to Canada, that's your business. We went in defense of our country as we saw it. We didn't care about the politics at the time. It's what we thought was right. It's the same as the Civil War, almost identical scenario. You had brothers at home that were against it. You might wind up getting in a verbal argument about it. But again, right guys, possibly wrong war. It doesn't matter. We want the war for our country. The hills are
alive with the in theaters, Julie Andrews danced through the Swiss Alps to the sounds of music. On the radio, the Beatles led the British invasion. But on TV, America was watching Vietnam. For the first time, a war fought across the world was watched in living rooms during dinner, as though it were happening right outside the window. For the first time, the horrors of war were seen up close and personal, laid out in its harshness and despair. For the first time, we didn't like what we saw. War wasn't a movie with John Wayne and Gary Cooper. It was real.
The first day we arrived in country, we were attacked. We were hit by rockets. We took incoming. I'd never experienced anything like that before, and I finally got settled in my bunk. Had my mosquito net around my bunk, and we were in a transitional period, getting ready to get shipped to our units. And that very same night, we got hit with rockets, and there were casualties. I found myself just running, and I didn't know where I was going. I was just following the crowd. And I can remember the fear. I can remember the fear and not knowing what to do, and thinking in my mind, this is my first day here, and I'm already doomed.
It cost me a very good friend one time. I'd picked a guy, a good Marine, for he didn't work out so well in Marine radio school, but in fact, he barely made it through. He was a hell of a good man to have in a fight. We were out near Dock To. And he was supposed to have the radio, but he had given it to another fellow, Pancho Dominguez, and well, okay, the shit hit the fan. Pancho was the first one hit. He went down with half his face blown off. And I got mad at John. I said, you asshole. You know, if someone was supposed going to get that radio from you, why didn't you tell me about it? Why didn't I get it? You know? I don't care that you gave it to him. You two guys worked something out for sea rats or whatever you did. I have no problem with that. But, I went off on John rather than focusing on the loss. It just, whatever it did to me, it made me a little weird, I guess. And we never did kiss and make up over that. But then again, maybe we didn't have to. We were the only two that came out.
Every soldier in combat faces the horror of war. It makes no difference if the battlefield is Lexington and Concord, the beaches of Normandy, or the Ho Chi Minh Trail. Just because the war in Vietnam wasn't as popular as some other conflicts doesn't mean that these servicemen were any less brave or true as they followed the orders of their country. So one would assume they'd be treated the same as any other returning veteran. Unfortunately, that wasn't exactly the case.
You went to tell somebody, hey man, I just came back from Nam. Like, so? It basically, that's what it was. They felt like you were, by being there, you were wrong, why go? So what do you want from us?
There was a little old lady that I was walking up the ramp as I was walking down. Now, I had not gotten to my family at that point yet, but and she looked at me and she said, Sonny, are you coming back from the war? And I said, yes, I am. And she said, God bless you. And I thought, gee, this is pretty neat. And after that, it was all downhill, really. It was something like, you want to get out of your uniform and forget that you were there, because it really wasn't, you know, very well accepted place to be coming from.
I felt proud that I was a Vietnam veteran, but I don't feel like society accepted that. You know, they didn't really care, you know, that you were in the service or even that you were over in Vietnam.
What did that do to you?
That made me hurt inside, that I didn't care.
It's been said, it's not whether you win or lose, it's how you play the game. But not in this case. It didn't matter whether we won or lost in Vietnam, and it wasn't a question of how we played the game, although many asked that question, and some didn't like the answers they found. The important thing to remember is the soldiers who went and fought and even gave their lives were not nameless, faceless statistics to be entered in the record books and forgotten. They were Berks County's sons and husbands and fathers and brothers.
I had gone into town, and when I came back, it was like 30 people around our place, and the ambulance was backed up to our bungalow, and I immediately thought of my son. You know, he had planned to go out water skiing, but I saw him, and he told me, it's Dad. So the woman that I knew, the oldest woman in that little community, when they put my husband in the ambulance, he was already gone, she just took me in her arms and she whispered to me that Tom was killed.
It's just a terrible blow to the family. It's something you think of every day. He's in my prayers every day, and all the boys that lost their lives. You just have to live around the situation, but it's something you never, never forget.
I was in third grade, and my dad came to the door, and I was talking to all the kids, which I shouldn't have been doing, and they were telling me that my dad was at the door, and I didn't believe him. I wouldn't turn around. I was supposed to eat lunch at school that day, and I turned around, and my dad was at the door, and I left with him, and I was walking down the hall, and I kept asking him, what's the matter? Why am I not eating at school today? And he came right out and told me that Roddy was killed in the war. And I just broke down and cried at that age. My brother was, he was a big brother to me. I didn't see him much because he was away at college, and but I must have idolized him every time he came home. You know, we waited.
They deserve to be remembered and honored and thanked, and they weren't. There was no parade on March 29th, 1973, the day the last American troops were withdrawn from Vietnam. The nation as a whole tried to put this terrible nightmare behind us, and in doing so, slighted the men who'd given so much of themselves to their country. America's involvement in Vietnam did not end in the spring of 73. The physical battles were over, but the emotional wars had just begun.
Healing will return in a moment.
Palmer Design Services Incorporated creates a total living or working environment with a full range of interior design services. Our experienced professionals are members of the American Society of Interior Designers, the country's most respected professional design organization. Palmer Design oversees every phase of your project, from home consultation and space designs to wall and window treatments to custom furnishings. Whether it's your home, showroom, or office, let Palmer Design Services create the right environment for you.
There are millions of brave Americans across our countryside who
crew answered when their country called, defended her with pride.
The Disabled American Veterans is proud to serve our veterans and their families. The DAV Field Service Unit will be in your area soon with free service on veterans benefits.
We're here to serve you. We're the DAV.
Check your local newspaper for schedules.
Reading Eagle Company is proud to have been part of the creation of the Vietnam Memorial. Through the effort of our employees, the Reading Eagle and the Reading Times provided extensive coverage of the dedication and the events leading up to it. Bill Kearns and Andy Lewandowski of our pressroom staff and Tom Stout of our editorial staff are Vietnam veterans who worked very hard to make the memorial dream a reality. And we are proud of the way the people of Berks County pulled together in this effort. Reading Eagle Company will remember.
The physical battles of the Vietnam War were fought in the jungles and rice paddies. But emotional battles were fought by the soldiers in their own hometowns. The physical battles were fought with firearms and napalm. The emotional weapons were thanklessness and apathy. Unlike the returning heroes from other wars, there were no ticker tape parades for the Vietnam veterans, very few welcome home banners, and celebrations were confined to family and friends. The average American tried to forget the horrors of Vietnam as quickly as possible, and those who suffered were the ones who fought.
The worst part of it, coming home. For me, I was happy I was coming home. You know, I was going to see all the people that I know, and back to stateside civilization, good food, warm showers, all that, and it wasn't exactly the same. Things had changed considerably in the short period of time that I was gone, and I didn't realize most of the changes were in me, but they had changed, and the people didn't view me the same way. I had a young lady spit in my face.
I was 20 and a half, still couldn't buy beer, and got to the airport in Los Angeles and had to endure a number of jeers, catcalls, and I couldn't understand it. For the longest time, I was convinced they weren't talking to me. They had me mixed up with somebody else. When I got on the plane, when I got up, changed planes in Chicago, I went into a store there in the airport and bought civilian clothes and changed in a men's room there, because I didn't want the same thing to happen in Philadelphia.
The families and friends of those who did not return still struggle with the significance of their sacrifice.
Did your son die in vain?
I've asked myself that question a million times. When I talk to some of the boys, in which I've lost one son, but I gained a lot of sons through this, and I've talked to many of them. One day I think he did, and the next day I think he didn't. I'm still questioning that.
Fortunately, the passage of time and the benefit of hindsight have allowed us to see the wrongs we'd wrought on the Vietnam veteran. Books, movies, and television shows have begun to explore the era with a candor that was unthinkable until this time, allowing for a greater understanding of what Vietnam was truly like. The idea of paying tribute to the Berks Countyans who served in Vietnam was born 150 miles from here at a shiny black wall that reflects not only faces, but thoughts and memories as well. It was in the winter of 1983 A Vietnam vet by the name of Andrew Lewandowski made the pilgrimage to Washington, D.C. to see the National Monument, which pays tribute to those who'd fallen in the war in which he too had fought.
It's awesome. It's an unbelievable memorial. I guess the first thing I did, I could feel myself mentally putting blocks up. I was there and I walked in front of it, but I wasn't really there. I felt all my defense mechanisms falling into place, not letting myself, you know, really think about it in a personal way. I came back later that evening and then, you know, I started caught up with the crying, etc. I looked for a couple buddies on it and they were there.
While the erection of the National Monument in 1982 began the healing process, something more immediate, more personal, closer to home was needed.
Watching the feelings and the interaction between that memorial and the people, and especially the veterans, caused me to start thinking about the need for a memorial, or the need for many memorials all over to kind of take care of the suffering and the hurt that was still going on from the war.
The need was there. The idea was forming. Now the dream needed a chance at reality.
In September, I guess, of 1985, we were incorporated. A guy named Bill Kern loaned us money for the incorporation. The president of VVA was present at the time. He was with us also. He was very much for it. The only problem was very hard to motivate the membership or any Vietnam veterans at that time. And, you know, that you have to remember that was before all these movies and the understanding that seems to be coming from society now. This was, you know, when people still weren't sure, and we were rather unpopular.
The design of a Marine Corps veteran from Maryland named Anthony Jafreda was chosen as the symbol with which we could remember Berks Countyan's efforts in the war.
The design concept of the memorial it takes in actually three kind of design techniques or something. First you have the bronze figure, which is full size. It's a military man who has a helmet and a flak jacket on, but no rifle. He has no eyes or mouth. And like I said before, he's full size. He represents almost anyone you want him to represent. He can be anyone, any one of your friends. You can actually sit on the step and put your arm around him. And then the other part of the design is the large boulder, which is roughly, well, we started at 6 foot high and 8 foot long, but it's kind of been whittled down. It was made to look natural, like it just came out of the earth, without saws and explosives, etc. When you see the steps, that kind of gives you the feeling, or it almost tells you how you should feel or what it means. And then as you go further and see the soldier, it's very easy to think about someone you might have known, or someone you might have lost in Vietnam. And then, of course, you go up to the big boulder, and there, in fact, are the names of Berks County's heroes, or the guys from Berks County who were killed.
Through the efforts of the Greater Reading Board of Realtors, the fundraising effort swelled with incredible community support, easily raising more than $200,000 to construct the memorial.
This memorial is for everyone, for the whole community. Hopefully some way, some part of that memorial will help people, all types of people, deal with their personal problems or their personal feelings of that war.
Through the efforts of dedicated volunteers, the memorial began to take shape. All that was needed now was a well-deserved welcome home parade.
Return to A Time of Healing after these messages.
My husband served almost 4 years in the military, in the Marines,
And during the ceremony, you could see the pride come out, proud of being a Marine, proud of being an American. And when it was time to salute the flag, he was as straight and staunch as though he was still in the service. The camaraderie, you know, just to see those people, it was absolutely great.
Arlington National Cemetery, a place where America comes to remember those who manned the trenches in World War I, those who stormed the beaches of Normandy in World War II, those who fought on the frozen Korean Peninsula and the rice paddies in Vietnam. They're remembered here. Their sacrifices will never be forgotten.
Former Design Services Incorporated creates a total living or working environment with a full range of interior design services. Our experienced professionals are members of the American Society of Interior Designers, the country's most respected professional design organization. Palmer Design oversees every phase of your project, from home consultation and space designs to wall and window treatments to custom furnishings. Whether it's your home, showroom, or office, let Palmer Design Services create the right environment for you.
It was time to resolve the conflict of the Vietnam War. The government had stopped the fighting in 1973. Now, we had to bridge the gap between the community and the Vietnam veteran. Time to say welcome home and thanks with a parade the likes of which this county had never seen. Bands were playing that day, September 24th, 1988, trumpeting the return of our Vietnam veterans. Every high school band in the area, 18 in all, marched in the same parade. Even a makeshift group from Holy Name, which has no marching band, formed a unit to show its support. And they were just a portion of the more than 100 units in this joyous event.
I think it's a great turnout. Best turnout we've had in years in this city.
It's about time that they did this, and people are really going to appreciate what they're doing. And it's a shame they still have MIAs and POWs still in that they can't get out. But we're glad they're doing it. We're glad they're doing it.
I think it's great that, you know, we set the day apart and pause to recognize them and remember them. You know, I like some of the banners already that, you know, came out, the issues, you know. It's good for our community.
Waited close to 20 years for this day, and I think it's beautiful. It's neat.
I'll tell you what, I was driving out 13th Street yesterday on the way home from work, and I got tears in my eyes when I saw the signs. It means a lot of people went to war for our country, and this parade is long deserved to welcome them home. It did. It made me really sad, and I'm upset for the people that got lost there.
The Welcome Home Parade had three grand marshals, the Berks Countyans still missing in action. A grim reminder, this happy occasion was a solemn one as well. Let's pause a moment to go back in time, 1 week before the parade, to another gathering held in honor of those still missing in action. Over 2,500 men were listed as prisoners of war or missing in action during the Vietnam War, 118 of those from Pennsylvania. Each year, friends and loved ones come together in City Park to float candles in the pond, one for each man, as a symbol of remembrance.
Forchar, Andrew Anthony J., E3, North Vietnam, 9 April, 70.
Scattered crowds listened to the names of the missing, read aloud during the night-long vigil. Hopeful calls, awaiting an answer that has yet to come.
What will really heal is when we bring our last brother home. Whether he be dead or whether he be alive. We'd prefer bringing him home alive, but we know that there are some that are KIAs over there. And we're trying to get, we want to get them all home. But with this, it's just like any other war. The government says, well, let's pull out. And you step up and say, hey, wait, we got 20,000, 30,000 men over here. Forget them, they don't exist no more. The government leaves people behind.
I stare at the gray walls before me. I see her face in stone. I try to imagine our baby. I wish they would let me go home. I wish they would let me go home.
return to A Time of Healing after this.
Reading Eagle Company is proud to have been part of the creation of the Vietnam Memorial. Through the effort of our employees, the Reading Eagle and the Reading Times provided extensive coverage of the dedication and the events leading up to it. Bill Kearns and Andy Lewandowski of our pressroom staff and Tom Stout of our editorial staff are Vietnam veterans who worked very hard to make the memorial dream a reality. And we are proud of the way the people of Berks County pulled together in this effort. Reading Eagle Company will remember. Television station for all seasons. WTVE, TV 51, Reading.
There are millions of brave Americans across our countryside who answered when their country called, defended her with pride.
The Disabled American Veterans is proud to serve our veterans and their families. The DAV Field Service Unit will be in your area soon with free service on veterans benefits.
We're here to serve you. We're the DAV.
Check your local newspaper for schedules.
It wasn't a time for chatter. It really wasn't. It wasn't a time to discuss anything. It was a time to thank God that they were finally recognized. You know, they wanted to show the fact that I'm proud to have done what I did. And there was no need to talk. It was just a time to sit, watch, and just thank God that this is over with. You know, finally they're somebody.
If you haven't seen Kutztown University lately, you've missed a lot. We still produce excellent teachers, but we've expanded our horizons into business, science, television, research, and much more. Come and take another look. You might be surprised.
Johnny came marching home from Vietnam. He marched alone. But when he marched home again, albeit symbolically, he was in good company.
City. I came up from York. I feel the butterflies. It feels like the real thing.
I feel coming home now. I feel that this is a necessity. There are other veterans out there that aren't as fortunate as me. The awareness of what's going on here will help the people understand what went on and the reason why a lot of veterans feel the way they do.
It's something we should have done a long time ago for everybody. You recognize who was lost, okay? And you're not memorializing or patronizing war, but the object is to make people understand what this was all about and who really sacrificed what, okay? And that's the only way you can do it. And you do it right. You do it in a very upfront and proper way.
Well, it is helpful and very reassuring, tremendously reassuring, to know that your community, you know, thinks enough of you, has thought enough of us to build a memorial in our honor.
One of the parade's most moving brigades was that of the Marching Vietnamese, offering thanks to the Americans who tried to save their homeland.
Members of this group of the Vietnamese community are coming from Berks County and other parts of the country, including Massachusetts, Connecticut, New York, New Jersey, and all over. Many of them themselves were officers and servicemen of the former South Vietnamese Armed Forces. We're carrying a Vietnamese flag. And we say thank you to the Vietnamese community.
The most important marchers this day, by far, were the veterans who went and fought, but received little or no recognition for their efforts when they came home. This was the Veterans Day, and they made the most of it.
Okay, here they come. Here they come.
At last, they had the homecoming they deserved. But a part of them will never come home.
I think we all have a degree of guilt that we harbor for having come back. It's like you didn't give enough of yourself or something. And it's hard to put into words, but I think we all have that sense of failure from the standpoint that that some of our friends didn't come back.
I was one of the chosen that God says, well, we're going to send this guy here, he's going to make it back. This guy we're going to send over and he's going to go.
It's very hard. It's very hard to explain. Sometime you feel maybe they were the lucky ones. Like they say, all is fair in love and war, so some of us came back. It's tough.
Return to A Time of Healing after this.
Reading Eagle Company is proud to have been part of the creation of the Vietnam Memorial. Through the effort of our employees, the Reading Eagle and the Reading Times provided extensive coverage of the dedication and the events leading up to it. Bill Kearns and Andy Lewandowski of our pressroom staff and Tom Stout of our editorial staff are Vietnam veterans who worked very hard to make the memorial dream a reality. And we are proud of the way the people of Berks County pulled together in this effort. Reading Eagle Company will remember.
Palmer Design Services Incorporated creates a total living or working environment with a full range of interior design services. Our experienced professionals are members of the American Society of Interior Designers, the country's most respected professional design organization. Palmer Design oversees every phase of your project, from home consultation and space designs to wall and window treatments to custom furnishings. Whether it's your home, showroom, or office, let Palmer Design Services create the right environment for you.
AT&T, we are proud to number among our family members many Vietnam-era veterans. They bring to AT&T the same spirit, the same courage, the same honor they brought to our country. At AT&T, we remember.
Assembled in City Park, meeting old friends, making new ones, and reminiscing about a common past. They were all there for one purpose, one goal, to see the monument at last. The culmination of 5 years of hard work, dedication, sweat, and tears was about to be unveiled. Some of those who helped make it all happen were given a chance to speak.
Berks County many times, and we hear it, you've all heard it, Berks County is slow. Berks County is backwards. We can't get anything done in Berks County. Let the people who say that come here. Let the people who read that and write that come here and see this memorial.
And it's yours. It's yours. It's yours, brother. Sisters, too.
To rededicate ourselves to our homeland, to work for our homeland, to make this country a better place, to work with our children, to work with our governments, and to take leadership role in our community. That's our obligation. And I think some ways that you can guide yourself through that is by using these 65 men as your guide or as what you want to work for. I think it's very important to remember how really good they were and how much we love them, and to redirect that love.
Nearly 20 years ago, I put this uniform on. 17 years ago, I took this uniform off, and I hid it in a closet. But today, thanks to you, mothers, fathers, friends, my brothers have served with me in Vietnam. I'm proud.
Last patrol, the group which made the trek from the Vietnam Memorial in Washington to Reading, carrying the names of Berks County's war dead. Now, they carried the names to their final resting place in the base of the memorial. The families of those who gave their lives for their country made a slow, steady walk to the memorial, their faces a visible sign of conflicting emotions. At last, their lost loved one's sacrifices were being acknowledged, but it wouldn't bring them home, only bring back memories both sweet and bitter. The Gold Star mothers, mothers who lost their sons to the war. Theirs was to be the day's highest honor. It was the mothers who would unveil the monument, letting everyone read the names they knew so well. The name each woman chose for her child.
Of the everything that was done as far as the memorial, asking the Gold Star moms to do the unveiling, to me, is paying all of our sons a very big honor.
Out of school and just 18.
Finally, the Berks County Vietnam Memorial was there for all to see. A rock of granite, a list of names, a featureless man of bronze. So little, and yet so much. A symbol that the wounds of Vietnam were beginning to close. As the barricades were lifted away, the public descended on the monument until it disappeared in a sea of humanity.
We watched with tear-filled eyes when we saw good friends die. Of the magic dragon flew at night. Back home they said this war wasn't right, but they still sent us out to fight. In the heat and the rain and the mud.
Time of healing continues in a moment.
Arlington National Cemetery, a place where America comes to remember. To remember those who manned the trenches in World War I, those who stormed the beaches of Normandy in World War II, those who fought on the frozen Korean Peninsula and the rice paddies in Vietnam. They're remembered here. Their sacrifices will never be forgotten.
Former Design Services Incorporated creates a total living or working environment with a full range of interior design services. Our experienced professionals are members of the American Society of Interior Designers, the country's most respected professional design organization. Former Design oversees every phase of your project, from home consultation and space designs to wall and window treatments to custom furnishings. Whether it's your home, showroom, or office, let Former Design Services create the right environment for you.
The families were invited to come over to view the monument and have it unveiled. And the vets were standing along the path and clapping. They weren't clapping for me, and they weren't clapping for the other families. But for the first time, I witnessed somebody clapping for Mike, and that was important.
Thank you.
It would be foolish to assume that a parade and a memorial could put all the pain of the Vietnam War behind us. The past can neither be forgiven nor forgotten in a single day. It takes time for forgiveness, and what happened in Vietnam should never be forgotten. But the day, September 24th, 1988, will hold its place in history as the day Berks County turned out to thank those who served in Vietnam and honor those who never made it back.
To those who laughed, to those who cried, to those who fought, to those who tried, to those who gave their very lives, we remember.
Yeah, they were heroes then. They're still heroes today.
They did an awful lot of work. Lee Callis in there.
Somebody get Stout in step.
And there's our honor guard from the Reading Bureau of Police.
Colonel Thomas W. Dugan. United States Air Force. December 13, 1968. In Laos.
Go ahead.
What do you have, my face in there? No.
The preceding program has been brought to you by the AT&T family, Meridian Bank, Metropolitan Edison Company, Ludgate Engineering Corporation, the R.M. Palmer Company, and by the Reading Eagle Company.
Kutztown University, originally established to train teachers for the classrooms of Pennsylvania, has come a long way. Kutztown has grown into a vibrant, multifaceted university, boasting 5 specialized colleges, more than 50 degree programs, and over 6,900 students. Still, we continue to produce excellent teachers at such a rate that most of the active teachers in our 5-county service area graduated from Kutztown.
We're TV 51, WTVE, Reading.
You're watching the Home Shopping Club on TV 51 in Reading.
New. It's a big jewelry box. Tony's waiting to find out what the baseball score is. Yes, he is. Is that Tony Kubek or what? Who is that out there? Look how big this is. Now, I like something I like most of all about this one. If I can put my hand in here. Can I do that, Sandy? I can't. She said, no, don't touch that. Right here. Just want to take a look at this one. Oh, now this is nice. You can pull out a drawer here for pendants. Got 4 drawers. Now this is something else. This will store the entire family's jewelry. Especially nice little brooches and pins, necklaces and bracelets. All sorts of interesting deals. Now look at the design on the door as we close it up. Look at that. What a sharp looking jewelry box. The ladies would love this. This is nice. The ring bolsters are here. Maybe we'll open that up again. This has it all. I like that revolving ring bolster. And the golden oak finish on there is superb. First time shoppers, only $80 to pick up on this one tonight. The lines are coming in at a feverish pace, as I would expect them to at this point in the show.
At least you are the leader. Now all you have to do, Clara, is beat 40 cents and you're in the showcase. Here she goes. Our representative from Hutchinson, Kansas has bonus spin, because there are no more contestants to spin. Now be sure you get it all the way around or it doesn't count and you don't get spin again. Spin it hard. Okay, now that'll get around once, but will it get around here again? I don't think it's gonna make it, Clara. But you do have $1,000, you do have a spot in the showcase, and we would like to share this with you.
What about the mover? I cannot hear you. Look, I'll call you right back. Hold on, Pop.
Once in a while, you really need a good long-distance connection.
A little hotline?
Call now and switch to Sprint. Get the best sound quality and save as much as 10, 20, even 30%.
Loved by the working man, craved by eager audiences, considered tasteful by people in high places. They're the California Raisins, and they're in Post Raisin Bran. Now you can get a cassette of the California Raisins' greatest hits. For details, check specially marked boxes.
I need home cooking.
Well, try Swanson Homestyle Recipe Number 6, a spicy beef lasagna with a blend of cottage, mozzarella, and ricotta cheeses you won't find anywhere else, unless your mother's Italian.
Sounds good.
She's not.
Since the turn of the century, there have been 16 presidents and one original Bengay. There have been 580 Nobel Prize winners and one original Bengay. There have been 12 men who've walked on the moon and one original Bengay. But now we're introducing a different formula, Bengay. Bengay Warming Ice. It goes on cool, then warms as its scent disappears. For fast relief of minor arthritis pain, Warming Ice. For Bengay, it's a once-in-a-lifetime introduction.
Temptation. Be tempted by the young and the restless.
When Ashley's private life becomes a public scandal...
The implications in the book are completely false.
There's only one woman Victor will blame.
Is Nikki really that capable of being so cruel?
Was it someone else who made that story so ugly?
Or is that the way you told it?
Weekdays on CBS.
The top winner in our showcase today, from Honolulu, Jumping LaTanya. The runner-up in our showcase today, from Hutchinson, Kansas, the ever-popular Clara. Each of you will have a showcase of beautiful prizes to bid on. One of you who bids closer to the actual retail price of your own showcase without going over will indeed win.